Things are warming up in the capital of Texas. A record crowd expected here today with two undefeated teams from the Big 12 South in what could be a point fest. This might be your last chance to catch your breath. This is the Austin calm before the storm, because the Cowboys are coming to Texas. Two of the nation's unbeaten square off in a shootout in God's country. Oklahoma State's explosive offense has decimated opponents all season long, and their defense is looking to knock off their longtime nemesis. Texas has been dominant throughout their climb to the top of the national rankings. Colt McCoy and the Longhorns don't want to relinquish their number one spot. It could come down to who wants it more. A sun-drenched crowd in Austin. We could have 99,000 on hand as ESPN's presentation of college football on ABC, presented by Best Buy, brings us a number one team in the country, the Longhorns of Texas, taking on the sixth-ranked Cowboys of Oklahoma State. Welcome to Austin, everybody. I'm Brad Nessler. This could be a dandy today. Obviously, both teams are unbeaten. Texas Tech has won today. Somebody's going to have to lose in this Big 12 South, and whoever does is out of the Big 12 picture and the national title hunt. So many great quarterbacks in this conference. We've seen them all year long. I bring in my quarterback, Bob Greasy. Grease, we got two good ones here today as well.
Well, you know, and I like the offenses, too. Two of the highest scoring offenses in the nation, both averaging over 47 points a game. And they're led by, well, you may know of Colt McCoy. He leads Texas, having a great year, completing over 80% of his passes. And then you may not have heard of Zach Robinson, but he's up there in the top five of passer rating also. Last year in this ball game, he threw for over 400 yards against Texas. This should be fun.
Both of those guys can run the ball as well. This is an anxious Texas team at home. Stacy's right down there with them in the tunnel.
They're so anxious behind me. There's a few words when I talk to these guys and when I have spoken with them throughout the week and just watching them right now, observing them. Conviction, energy, aggression. And when I talk to their quarterback, Colt McCoy, he said the first thing that he did this week is he came in and he watched the Oklahoma State film from last year. He said, "Stacy, we were so bad, I couldn't stomach the second half. It was disgusting." He turned the film off and he told me, "We need to have an aggressive start. We have to be fast against Oklahoma State because we haven't been like that in the past against them." They're ready to go, guys. I can assure you, they're ready to go, Brad.
All right, Stacy, you might as well turn them loose. The number one team in the country under Mac Brown, 7-0 for the second time in Mac's tenure. They're a team that's loaded. They started the preseason way down at number 11. Now they're number one. They want to stay there. They haven't lost to Oklahoma State in the last 10 years. In front of about 99,000 fans on a sunny day in the state capital of Texas. And here come the Longhorns. We're about to have some fun in the Big 12, everybody. Stick around. Texas and Oklahoma State next. Texas Memorial Stadium in Austin, Oklahoma State, the visitor. Mac Brown's Longhorns, the number one team in the country. Stacy's with the coach.
Coach, you've gotten off to some slow starts against Oklahoma State. What pregame message did you give them like your mother's been telling you to give them?
We need to give them the respect that we give Oklahoma because they've got great players. This is the best Oklahoma State team we've seen, and this is not a game we need to get behind in.
You're in the midst of a really tough Big 12 stretch. How have you kept your guys consistent being the hunted?
We want to be the hunted. You came to Texas for that, and it's an exciting time for us.
All right, Coach, thank you very much.
Speaking of hunting, we're always worried about Paul because he's been known as a cattle rustler in the past.
Hey, Ness, I'm down here with Coach Bevo. You can see Coach Bevo. One final question, Coach. I know we've been talking. How are you going to slow down the Oklahoma State offense? Really? You're kidding. Seriously, you're a little bullish, aren't you, on Texas? Well, this is what Coach Gundy had to say, how they were going to try to slow down Texas's offense.
Well, we really have to be disruptive to Colt. He's playing really well right now, and they're balanced. They've got a good plan, but we have to be blitz, zone, mix it up, not give them a good feel for what we're doing defensively so we can keep them disrupted.
Hey, you know this? I swear, I really don't think I believe either one of them.
Get to your cart. Paul's on his way to the cart. We're on our way to a couple of undefeated teams. Oklahoma State won the toss. They deferred. So they'll be kicking off to the high-powered Longhorn offense. As Bob said, Texas number two in the country in scoring. The Cowboys number four in the country in scoring. We also saw what Texas Tech can do earlier today as they roll to a win, and they await Texas next Saturday night in Lubbock. Something's got to shake out, and something's going to shake out of this game. Dan Bailey to kick. Juan Cosby and Jordan Shipley back deep. And it is a deep kick. Cosby about 3 yards in will bring it out. Really took a shot as he got near the 18 or 19 yard line. Blake Gideon on the special teams made the hit. There's Colt McCoy. We talked with him about what he wants to accomplish on the opening series.
We've talked about it all week. Finish the race. Now keep your eye on the prize and come out strong. Come out hard, just like we did last week, and score a lot of points early, because their offense is really explosive. They can score, you know, a lot of points. So we're going to have to be on our game and come out strong.
It's a gauntlet for Texas. They beat Oklahoma 2 weeks ago, Missouri last week, and now here's another undefeated. First down for the Longhorns. The quick toss is out to Cosby. And Cosby takes it out for about four to the 24-yard line. As we take a look at our Texas Impact players presented by Best Buy. Quan, who made the first catch, is one of them. That's 39 straight games now. We couldn't change that one fast enough for you. Cody Johnson, all he does is score touchdowns when they get down close. And on defense, look out for Brian Arakpo coming around the corner if you're Zach Robinson. Second down and six with a ball just outside the 24-yard line. Obanaya is in there. The quick toss, though, is out again, complete. And it's pitch and catch, but they didn't get much on that one. Maybe three more yards out to Cosby again.
Oklahoma State came up and threatened a blitz. Colt saw it and just pitched the ball out to his wide receiver to avoid any kind of sack or any kind of pressure.
You see the defensive alignment on top of the scoreboard there for the Cowboys of Oklahoma State. Just a freakish 81% completion percentage. Last week at one point, Colt hit 17 in a row. Third down and two, and he's all by his lonesome in the Longhorn backfield. First down throw is complete. Out to the 31 to Malcolm Williams.
When you throw those short passes, Brad, out to the wide receiver, you're going to complete a high percentage of them.
Well, the game plan involves number 12.
Well, for Oklahoma State, you need to make some big plays on offense, defense, and special teams. And just turn the young Colt loose. Just keep doing what you've been doing.
Well, the young Colts 3 out of 3 for starters here. First down, Texas at the 31. Play action. This time they get pressure on McCoy. He gets away from one, but not the second. Hugo Chinasa on the sack and a loss of four.
I'll tell you this, Hugo Chinasa, he went after the ball, and he almost has it because Colt McCoy doesn't see him coming from the backside. He's going to come in from his backside. Watch this. He's number 91. He goes around. Now watch. He comes back in again and almost gets the football.
Just a three-man rush. Lemon, the linebacker, forced him out of the pocket.
Mike Gundy's offense getting a lot of points, but the defense getting better in the past few weeks. 0-3 against Texas, but had big leads in some of those games. Here's a crossing pattern. There's the first drop ball of the day. James Kuykendall was thinking about where he was going with the football before he took it along. So that'll bring up third down and long now. Texas is great in third down conversions. This will be a big one, though. They're fourth in the country at 55%. But Mack Brown's team's got to get all the way out across the 41-yard line to pick up this one. Three wideouts for McCoy. On third and long, Oklahoma State might blitz again. They'll bring an extra man. McCoy has time, rifles it complete. First down and more. All the way to midfield to Kirkendall, the guy that just dropped the other one.
That is so good. You saw the linebackers jumping in and out. Jumping in and out of the protection was there. Watch the linebackers. They're jumping, bouncing in, bouncing out. They send five guys. Everybody's picked up. Good job up front. Colt sees the coverage. Kirkendall gets open, breaks the tackle, first down. Big third down conversion on the first drive of the game.
22-yard pickup on that third down and long. John Chiles is in, and he's in motion toward the ball. He's the backup quarterback. He sets up with Colt McCoy now. Might be a little option to Chiles. It is. Oklahoma State did a nice job defensively. T.J. Bell made the stop, pickup of about two. And Mack Brown told all of us yesterday, he said, unconventional is the way we're approaching this. We're going to pull out all the stops. They got some trick plays. They got some things they're going to try just to keep his team loose and keep Oklahoma State on its heels a little bit.
Yeah, don't be surprised. They pitched that to Chiles, the backup quarterback. He can throw it. He can also run it. Mack said he's probably a better runner than he is a thrower right now.
Eighth play of the drive already on the opening possession. Now to give is to Vondrell McGee, and he got a couple. Texas does not have a big-time tailback like they've had for so many years, the Cedric Bensons and the Ricky Williams and all those guys, Jamal Charles. Right now, Colt McCoy is the leading rusher, and a lot of people look at that and say, that's the one problem this team has, but they kind of do it by committee.
7-0 is not a problem.
No, it's not.
And I'll tell you another thing. All these guys looking right over here at me, I'm going to give a signal on one of these downs. Maybe they'll take my play.
They won't listen to you like Bevo didn't listen to you.
Four wide receivers, McCoy, backpedals, trying to get a screen out there. They finally do. There's no blockers, though, and a big hit at about the line of scrimmage put on Vondrell McGee by Levine and Lemon. Oh, man.
Yes, let me tell you something. This thing is right here in front of me, and number 41, Lemon, just zeroes in. And you talk about a great hit. There was no place for the Ben back to go except right into Lemon.
He came to Oklahoma State as a quarterback, of all things.
Thank you very much.
This is a freshman punter, Tucker, and he's going to more than likely rugby-style punts. They've had trouble with their punting team, and they're trying to keep it out of the hands of the return men for Oklahoma State. There's the rugby-style punt, and it's a dandy, but it's going to go too far. Unless it went out of bounds.
There you go.
Oh, it did. It's a lot better kick than I thought from my angle. Great kick. Out of bounds at the six on the line drive. So Oklahoma State in a little bit of a hole, but they've got the football when we come back. Not exactly your Zach Robinson where you want to start your opening drive. The Cowboys at their own six. Hunter, the tailback, is in the end zone. Play action. On the roll, Robinson's going to keep it. He's got good wheels, and he gets in a little more breathing room out to about the 13-yard line. Earl Thomas came out. Zach Robinson's no dummy. He knows what it's like to be in Austin and what he needs to do on the first series.
We want to keep the crowd, you know, as much, you know, out of it as we can. We know that it can get pretty loud here, and so, you know, just kind of set the tone and hopefully keep the crowd out of the game.
He does a good job of it with a completion to his tight end for a first down across the 30. Brandon Pettigrew, a big target, big-time blocker and a big-time receiver as well. He's been kind of banged up this year, healthy now, and there's the first down.
He was the All-Big 10, All-Big 12 tight end by the coaches last year. He's been hurt the last three and a half games. They big plus getting him back in this offense, Brad.
There's Zach Robinson's numbers, 70%. That seems meager when you're talking about Colt McCoy's 81. So many good quarterbacks in this conference, and he's one of them. In the gun on first down. Fakes the toss to his tailback and wanted to come back across the middle to Pettigrew. I think it hit Russell Okung, his left tackle, in the back of the head as we take a look at our Oklahoma State Cowboy Impact Players presented by Best Buy. There's Kendall Hunter leading the conference in rushing, closing in on 1,000 yards. This guy, Dez Bryant, is one of the best receivers around. They really know how to get him the football. And Andre Sexton, kind of a combination linebacker safety type, will really get after you on defense. Second down and 10. Inside handoff. And across the 35 goes Toston, picked up about three. Well, you know, you talk about key matchups, we talk about high-powered offenses. How about when you're talking about one of the best ground games in the country against one of the best rush defenses in the country?
And the defensive line for Texas is going to be key. That front four has got to control the offensive line of Oklahoma State.
The Cowboys, a 48% third down conversion team. They've got third down and seven here. As they look to the sideline to get the call, crowd really coming for the Texas defense here. Robinson stands tall, delivers, first down on the run, Pettigrew again.
Yes, you got to really look at this. You talked about the offensive line against the defensive line of Texas. And this time, these guys just held him out. Zach had all the time in the world to throw this ball and to wait for his tight end to clear coming across the middle. This was just perfect pass blocking for the offense.
Now a more conventional look by Bryant Ward being in there at fullback in front of Kendall Hunter on a first down from midfield. Again, the play action bootleg. Robinson running for his life. Got away. Didn't get back to the line of scrimmage, though. Ran a long ways to get tackled by Melton and Houston. Loss of a couple. Well, these guys, they were going right that time, but they'll be going left in Atlanta tomorrow. Jimmy Johnson looking to score his second straight win. Got a lot of guys nipping at his heels. Chase for the NASCAR Sprint Cup continues in Atlanta on ABC tomorrow. Countdown begins at 1 o'clock Eastern time. I'm taking the 48 car because he knows how to drive in Atlanta.
Not because he's in the lead by us.
I like that, too. I like that.
Insurmountable mount.
I like that, too. I don't mind being a front runner. It doesn't bother me. Second and 12. Robinson, middle screen. Breaking tackles. Oh, and a trip up at the last second. Great play by Jared Norton, the middle linebacker. Or that one could have been a big gainer to Toston.
Yeah, it was there. All he needed to do was get away from Norton. I like the tempo that the Cowboys are using. They come out. They started inside their own 10-yard line. I like what this drive is doing. They're moving the ball. A lot of different plays.
They're in the eighth play of this drive, but it's third down and 10. Zach Robinson calmly stands in the gun, and it's Pettigrew, his big tight end in motion to the slot on the right side. There comes a slip screen, and it slips in and out of the hands of Dez Bryant. And let's check in with Stacy.
Well, Brad, I'm joined with prominent oil baron T. Boone Pickens with Oklahoma State. And obviously, $165 million to the program, but you've lost over the past several months over $1 billion. How has that halted your progress on the campus?
Well, the OSU funds were with 300 other partners. So they, of course, haven't lost that. But where our program's on schedule, we'll do just exactly what we said we'd do. And on Monday, I'll make another announcement as a major gift to the university. So we won't come out short. We will come out with more money than we went in with.
That's incredible, Boone. I'm sure a lot of people wonder, and not to spin it negatively, but what's it like to lose that much money?
Well, that's not any fun.
Yeah.
But, you know, I've been there before, so it... you know, everything will work out fine.
Well, I know you're proud of this program right now. We appreciate you joining us.
God, this is a great day today. This is going to be a big football game.
Thanks, Boone.
Sure.
So Texas way back at the 7-yard line following the punt, and they got very close to blocking this one. The Longhorns have got it back.
ESPN College Football on ABC, brought to you by Best Buy, You Happier, and Nissan, passionate about performance and proud sponsor of the Heisman Trophy.
The Capital Saddlery was founded in 1930 by T.C. Buck Steiner, and his family still owns and operates a business, finest custom handmade authentic leather boots and saddles created there. His babies would look good on McGuire. Especially when he's down there chasing Bevo around.
If I'd have had a saddle, I'd have jumped on that big guy. You know that?
You know, when you're inside the 10, doesn't really mean much to Texas. They've had four drives that have covered more than that. Two of them against Oklahoma a couple of weeks ago. Bevo is up and very happy right now. You can tell that's his happy face.
Right now his Longhorns, though, start at the 7-yard line.
How can you tell?
He has pretty much the same look all the time, so you just kind of wing it. Assume he's happy.
That big boy got some bad breath, though, I'll tell you.
McCoy on the give and a loss on the play. Obaniah Chinasa makes another nice stop and loses his headgear in the process.
That's one of the things that I'm seeing just down here that we keep an eye on during the course of this game is when you see Colt McCoy fake that ball or put it in the gut of the back coming around. There is a defensive lineman staying home on every one of these plays.
Well, they're accounting for Colt because he's Longhorns leading rusher. He has not run by design yet today. Greg Davis, the offensive coordinator, says about five runs we line up a game, and then he has about five more where he scrambles on his own. This quick throw got him out across the original line of scrimmage. Pickup of about three to Greg Smith. They don't use their tight ends much, but they use one there.
Greg Smith, he's an ex-offensive lineman. He weighs 295 pounds. Nobody on the defense is going to cover him, I guarantee you. He had no receptions coming into the ballgame.
So now it's third down and eight. And again, Colt McCoy might be near his own goal line before he throws this one. Whoa, what a strike. And he puts some Zuzu on that one out to the 24-yard line to Shipley. Well, third and long doesn't seem to bother Colt McCoy, at least not so far in this game.
Well, the patterns are good. The calls are good. Shipley is always in the slot, just going to go down and find an area that's open, hangs in there, gives him time. He's got great confidence in Shipley that if he comes back to him, he's going to get open.
So now they got some room to work at the 24-yard line. Here's the end around. Shipley, 35, stiff arm, and across the 40-yard line. So we take a look at our city X Factor. You might guess it, number eight. Not only a great receiver, but he had a 96-yard kickoff return for a score against OU. He just got 18 on the end around. They've been using that play since back with Vince Young and all other kinds of guys on that little just flip on the end around, and it worked to perfection there.
Give the offensive coordinator, Greg Davis, credit for getting it called at the right time and getting them away from their own end zone.
Now they're out to the 41. McCoy got a man open, complete across the 50. Obaniah. And they're trying to slow down this Texas offense, and Andre Sexton, one of their best players, talked with us about how you try to do that.
I think we have to, you know, attack Colt and, you know, disguise different coverages and just come at him from different angles. And, you know, we have to come at him like we did Chase Daniel and hopefully be successful like we did there and just try to contain him in the pocket.
Well, they had Chase Daniel, three interceptions in that game. So far, they've sacked Colt McCoy once, but now he's got the offense for Texas moving. This time he keeps it and gets down. And he got maybe 3 yards. Looks like a first down. As Colt McCoy, by design, running that one. I think you had a chat with him about getting down at the end of runs yesterday, didn't you?
I did. I saw Colt, and I said, I like a lot of what you're doing. He says, I saw a hit last week, though, against Missouri, that he just got clobbered. And as soon as I started talking about it, he knew what I was going to say. About the hit last week, he said, I know I should have got it down. I tried to get down. I tell every quarterback when I go to do these games, that when the party's over, get down.
He comes up throwing on first down and completes it down to the 44-yard line. We go out to New York and Matt Weiner. Matt.
Stay in the end zone.
Here's McCoy on the deep out. Looking for a flag as Collins and didn't get one. Brandon Collins was the intended receiver. Andre Sexton, who we just heard from, was the guy back there covering. Sexton, a combination linebacker, strong safety. They call him a star. It's kind of one of those bandit positions.
It is. It's all the defense is almost a 4-2-5. It's a kind of a built-in nickelback with Sexton being a half defensive back, half linebacker. Good player.
Well, here's another third down, but third downs haven't been a problem so far for Texas today. McCoy flushed a little bit, found an open man, little jump pass to Obaniah, who's got first down down to the 32-yard line. You know, so that's five. I'm sorry, Paul. That's five different receivers that Colt McCoy's hit on third down.
I was just going to say, this is the second time that Obanaya comes out of that backfield. One time it was just on a swing pass. This time he saw everybody was picked up in the backfield, and he just slips out into the flat. Just take a look. You'll see Obanaya come out now. He doesn't have to block anybody. Colt McCoy sees him, and the rest he does on his own.
But Colt saw that he got pressured, bought some time, scooted around, still kept his shoulders downfield, and the presence of mind to throw the ball downfield.
Here he is off play action. Might have wanted it all. Instead, he goes to Shipley inside the 15. And another strike by McCoy. T.J. Bell made the stop. And the two best friends since they were kids hooking up one more time. Our ESPN BioBlast on Colt McCoy. Up to 210 pounds now, 27-6 as a starter. The most touchdown passes in school history. And a touchdown pass in 30 of the last 33 career starts. And the guy he just threw that one to, they've been playing pitch and catch since they were little ones. Down inside the 15 to the 14-yard line. Wanted to throw a screen. Now the fade to the corner. Got him. Touchdown, Shipley. Now they're almost grown-ups, and they're still playing pitch and catch. Colt McCoy's 20th touchdown of the year.
It's coming right at you. Watch this throw. Shipley looks to the inside. It's what a perfect throw. That's the 152nd pass that he's thrown without an interception this year in this stadium.
Hunter Lawrence in for the point after. Right down the middle. Well, I said it didn't matter if they were 90-some yards away or not. Take it the length of the field. For the fourth time this year in five series, Texas has gone 90-plus for a touchdown. Seven nothing Texas after a 93-yard march in 11 plays, 4.5 minutes. Colt McCoy's 20th touchdown pass of the year to his buddy Jordan Shipley as Texas in front. As I mentioned, 90-plus four times they've scored out of the five times they've been buried that deep. And now Texas to kick off, and they want to keep it away from Victor Johnson and Parrish Cox. They're dangerous return guys, but they're going to kick deep. They're going to put it in the hands of Victor Johnson from about the three. Johnson found a seam. He might be gone. Texas will catch up with him, but not before he got into Longhorn territory. And that's exactly what we were talking about. Texas didn't want to do that. They kicked it deep, and he ripped them.
Mack Brown lied. He lied. He lied. He told us they were going to put a squib kick this ball. They kicked this ball deep all the way down to the 3-yard line. And just take a look at the blocking. Look at the speed and the agility of the runner. When they see those holes open up, if it weren't for the kicker, he would have scored a touchdown.
And now you've got to be salivating a little bit of your Oklahoma State. You're thinking, okay, they got a touchdown, but we're at their 45 with 1:34 left first quarter. And now they go to the ground, and they got a big gainer all the way to the 26-yard line for Kendall Hunter as he rips off 19 yards.
This Kendall Hunter is, listen folks, he's only 5 feet and he weighs 190 pounds. First of all, you got to find him. Then you've got to recognize him. And then you got to tackle him. Well, Texas didn't do either one of those things.
First down at the 27. Hunter to the left, only for about a yard this time. Brian Arakpo made the stop. There's number 24, and he's going to have 1,000 yards on the season. Before the day is done, he came in with 955. Obviously, when you have a guy that's short in stature, the comparisons are with Barry Sanders. I don't think you ever compare anybody with Barry Sanders, but he's quicker than he is fast, according to Will Muschamp, the defensive coordinator for Texas, but he was quick on that last one. Tostin takes his spot right now, and they fake it to him. Robinson loads, lost one for Pettigrew, and it's out of bounds, and so is Pettigrew, incomplete. And Arakpo put a hit on Robinson after he let go. Got a Who Am I for you. I held the NCAA record for most passes by a freshman without an interception from 86 until last week. Who would I be? Tell you after this play. I'll give you a hint. He was a quarterback that played for OSU. That's what Zach Robinson's doing right now on 3rd and 10.
As Dez Thomas, Dez Bryant down at the bottom of the screen.
They like to just throw a jump ball to him once in a while. This is going to be an option, though. Hunter on the cutback. Hunter fought the ball. Loose ball. Who's got it? Still piling on. Texas football. Hunter not only had the first down, he might have had a touchdown, but the ball came out, and the Longhorns have got it back.
I'll tell you what, Kendall Hunter, that you talk about making a cut and making a break. Watch this cut. Watch how fast he's in that hole. One step, now back up in, and he's at full speed. He just loses the ball. It's pulled out, and he almost gets back on the ball.
It was Kendall who recovered it after Earl Thomas stripped it out of there. So Sergio Kendall with a big play.
That's and only the 11th giveaway all season for the Cowboys.
Now Texas has got it back at their own 9-yard line. Wonder if they've got a 91-yard drive in them. You never know. They'll keep it on the ground. Chris Obanaya on the carry. T.J. Bell stopped him after a pickup of about 6. We didn't get a chance to answer the Who Am I quarterback who held the freshman record for consecutive passes without an INT. It was Mike Gundy before last week when the youngster over at Baylor broke his record. Mike, I still think, I was talking with him the other day, I said, I still think of you as a player, because I remember it wasn't that long ago, but you're starting to sound more and more like a coach every day.
He looks good. So I'm on the field before the ball game.
Well, his team has looked good until that fumble a few moments ago. We've played one. Texas out in front, the number one team, 7-0. State trailing Texas 7-0 as we enter the second quarter. Long touchdown drive by the Longhorns covered over 90 yards. Oklahoma State had a good one going of their own before the fumble that was recovered by the Longhorns at the 9-yard line. Colt McCoy on the give to Obanayo. He got out to maybe to the 17-yard line. Let's check in with Stacy.
Well, Brad, if you're wondering if the Oklahoma State players and coaches were discouraged by that turnover, not at all. In fact, head coach Mike Gundy went and patted every single player on the head. He was very encouraging. He said, great job. That was a terrific drive. Very positive. But Dez Bryant, wide receiver number one, he was very disappointed, and he actually looked at his players as if to say, hey, guys, we got to have better.
And that Texas, meanwhile, goes out. And they get a first down on a run by McCoy. Pickup of 9 on a third down. Third down has not been a problem. We welcome you back to the booth. Brad Nessler, Bob Greasy, Paul's on the cart. You just saw Stacy. Colt McCoy completes 81% of his passes. How's he do it?
Well, when he throws the deep passes to the sideline, you release it and you throw the ball a little higher. Here's the tip. On the shorter stuff, get your hands up. Get the linebackers and the defensive linemen, because you got to throw it flat. You can't throw it with a big arc. You got to throw it flat, and he throws it right over the heads. Get your arms up.
He loves this stadium, too. It's even better than 81% when he's at home. You look from behind him. Play action. Colt sets up. Now he's going to try to buy himself some time again and get down to the 27-yard line. Chinasa made another tackle. Pickup of a couple. And, Paul, your impressions. You've seen everything close up in the first quarter.
Close up and personal. And I'll tell you what, Colt McCoy did not look at you, Greasy, or listen to you, Greasy, because he didn't get down right then, Greasy. So you got to be a little bit more forceful when you talk to the quarterbacks.
Can you even see the field?
Not from where I am, no, but it doesn't matter.
They're going to come after Colt McCoy right here. Blitz, and here's the quick throw out to Cosby. Across the 35 and another first down. So it's either Cosby or Shipley.
Yeah.
6 or 8, and he just picks it and picks it and picks it apart.
Cosby has played 4 years of baseball. He'll be 26 in December. I'm reminded of Bobby Bowden when he had the quarterback.
Chris Winkie.
Chris Winkie says, I wish all my boys were 26.
Vondrell McGee comes into the Texas backfield. Yeah, Quan's got more in his mind than just football. He's got a family, too, to worry about.
Yep.
At the 37-yard line. Here's the end around with maybe a pass coming up. Cosby can throw, and he's going deep for Shipley. And a flag is down. There's that baseball arm Bob just talked about. Shipley was open for a moment. Ricky Price just trying to make up ground, and it's going to be pass interference.
We saw him working on this play yesterday.
Interference, defense, number 6. 15-yard penalty, automatic. First down.
First penalty of the game.
That was a very similar play, a reverse that they ran earlier in the game, Brad.
Yep.
And that just, you have to run the reverse first before you run the reverse pass.
Here's Quan Cosby coming around. As Bob said, Thursday in practice, he threw this one a little bit better than he did here. But still, not a bad ball at all. Shipley almost pulled it down with Price getting his hand in the way.
You know, I don't. If I see any pass interference, it's Shipley putting his hand out and pushing Price away.
That was close.
That's what Mike Gundy's saying, too.
Yeah, that was very close.
Mike Gundy's saying exactly what Paul's saying down there. So first down now at the 48-yard line of the Cowboys. McCoy zips it incomplete down to the 34-yard line again, and it's Quan Cosby again.
Now, Gracie, let me tell you something. If anybody ever questioned this guy's arm, where he puts this ball to Quan Cosby is perfect. It's between three different players. And I mean he puts it in right where Cosby can catch the football. This was a perfect throw.
Quan is playing in his 47th game. Comes in fourth in catches, fifth in yards. Over 4,000 all-purpose yards in his Texas career. Now they're going to try to blitz McCoy, and he rolls away from the heat, and he throws another strike to Brandon Collins in the other direction.
It's just classic. Greg Davis, the offensive coordinator, spreads the field from sideline to sideline, and this time rolls his quarterback out to make it an easier throw. In the pocket, outside the pocket, short passes, deep passes, got him moving everywhere.
8 different receivers Colts used as well. So he's mixing it up, and everybody's getting involved.
A lot of short passes, a lot of stuff under 15 yards.
First down now inside the 20. Mack Brown's team up a touchdown, 12 minutes left in the first half. And they're going to take a timeout. We'll take it with them. Longhorns on the drive. Can they score again? We'll find out when we come back. Paul, you get 15 or 20 more of those eye black things and you don't have a bald spot anymore.
Thank you.
First down at the 19. Colt McCoy has hit his last 6 passes. This is going to be McGee. McGee puts his head down and powers his way for a couple of extra yards. 205-pounder ran into the defense of the Cowboys and just kept driving forward.
I'll tell you what, McGee was coming right at us on his cart, and when he looked up, there were nothing but white shirts. He didn't see any burnt orange blocking for him, so he just lowered his head and still picked up 2 yards.
So now second down inside the 15. Second and 5. Cosby to the top of your screen. Shipley, the slot man, as always. They'll run it again, though, and McGee again, and a touchdown. Said earlier, do they have a 91-yard touchdown drive in them? Yep.
And you know another thing, Ness, if you run a play and it stopped for the first time, go ahead and run it again. That was the exact same play.
Hunter Lawrence for the point after. Kick is good with 11:13 remaining in the first half. Remember when Mack Brown told Stacy before the game, the key is to get a fast start and not let them get the lead? Guess what's happened in Austin? 14-0 Longhorns. Salt Lick Barbecue opened for business back in 69. Now world-renowned as having some of Central Texas' best barbecue in a rural setting. I think that's what we had before the game. It was darn good.
That looked good.
Well, Texas, 5 of 6 times now, starting inside their own 10, have gone for touchdowns twice today. The last one, a 91-yard march in 9 plays. The 14-yard touchdown by Vondrell McGee, and it's 14-0. Line drive kick goes to one of the up men at the 28, and he's buried at the 35-yard line as we head out to John Saunders in New York. John? All right, John, thanks. Here it's 14-0. Oklahoma State was held scoreless in that first quarter for the first time this year, and for the first time in the Cowboys' last 14 games. They haven't had the ball enough to get any scores. Now they're going to get it out complete to Dez Bryant for the first time today. And they'll continue to work number one, you can bet, because he's a big-time player at the wide receiver spot. Time right now for our trivia question for the week. What former Oklahoma State javelin thrower went on to become the best-selling solo recording artist in U.S. history? And the throw complete that time from Zach Robinson out to Pettigrew, his tight end, for a pickup of 11 and another first down. So Dez Bryant, number one, 87, Brandon Pettigrew. That's Zach Robinson's two main guys. There's a big fall off after that.
You got to get the ball to those two guys. Dez Bryant went the whole first quarter without touching it.
There he is, matched up with Curtis Brown on the corner. The Cowboys are back in Longhorn land at the 45. Here's a little bit of option. Robinson, a good runner. Nothing doing there, though. Maybe got about a foot. Henry Melton made the stop, number 37, the defensive end. And if you haven't seen a Longhorn game in a couple years, you're going, Henry Melton? I thought Henry Melton was a running back. Henry used to be a running back a couple of years ago, and he was a darn good one.
Yes, he was.
Well, Colt McCoy has thrown for a touchdown to Jordan Shipley. A great catch in the corner. Vondrell McGee following the fumble by Hunter. They went 91 more yards. And 14-0 right now. Longhorns in front. Robinson. Quick throw. Nice catch. Pettigrew diving out there. And he's going to be very close, if not having a first down. And he's a big target. Grease, 6'6", 255 pounds.
Came into the game with 81 career receptions and 9 touchdowns. He's a fifth-year senior. I said earlier he missed a few games with injury.
And Zach Robinson is going to get the first down himself.
And everybody says they just rave about this guy. They think that next April's draft, he's going to be one of the first tight ends taken.
Grace, you got to see the hands on this guy. When they show his, we got to take a look. Look at the hands on this guy up close. I'm telling you, and he makes every catch look easy. It just settles into his hands.
Paul, before the game, I was down there, and I shook hands with Dez Bryant. He's 6'2", and he's got arms almost down to his knees, and his hands hands are twice as big as anybody's.
At the 34, pump fake by Robinson, and now he's going to loft it to the corner for Bryant. And that time, those big hands could not come down with it. Nice defensive play by Curtis Brown, the sophomore out of Gilmer, Texas, who stayed right with number one. Mike Gundy calling the plays on your left.
Look at all the players looking over to the sideline.
Neither of these teams huddles, but neither team necessarily hurries. They can if they want to, but for the most part, it's look over to the...
But he's calling to some assistants who are wagging him in, signal the plays in.
Nice play fake. Robinson going to throw on the run, and this one's into the Texas bench.
There's the difference between Robinson and McCoy, between Zach and between Colt right there. He bought some time, but he's not accurate when he's moving, throwing the football.
Now he's facing a 3rd and 10. There's the call from the coach into the headset. The quarterback relays it to Kendall Hunter. And here's a big 3rd down. Pressure coming. Robinson throws. Complete. Dez Bryant. Wow, what a grab, and he dives for the first down.
Well, you know, you throw one to him and you knock it down and don't get in his face and say, you know, you can't catch it. But then they go right back and they throw it to him. And you take a look at Bryant on this catch. This is all hands, folks. And then watch what he does. He knows he doesn't have the first down yet. So now he dives for the first down.
And there's a run for a touchdown. Kendall Hunter scoots around the end for 23 yards. And Oklahoma State right back in the ballgame.
That's what this offense is. It's a quick strike, tempo one. Take your time, and then next play you get up and you go quick.
Well, they came in with 20 touchdown drives of five plays or less. That one didn't take them long. And the whistles and flags on the field.
Hey, Ness, look at the shoes on the kicker.
This was a hurry up, a quick count, which is great. You take so much time a lot of times at the line of scrimmage. Come up there sometimes and go very quickly so the defense can't get set.
So now Dan Bailey, gold shoes. I guess those are orange. The golden toe.
I'm sorry.
For the extra point. Oklahoma State's right back in the ball game, capping a 65-yard drive with a touchdown. And we said Kendall Hunter would be on his way to a 1,000-yard season sometime today. He's got it now after capping off that touchdown drive. Zach Robinson talking with head coach Gundy. He's going to take a seat while the defense goes out there. Meanwhile, Malcolm Williams awaiting Dan Bailey's kickoff. 14-7 Texas. Kind of misjudged the kick, and it's going to go out the back of the end zone, and Texas will have to start from their own 20-yard line. Thursday coming up at 10-9 Central, all new Life on Mars. The next great cop show has arrived. Starring Michael Imperioli, Harvey Keitel, Jason O'Mara and the gang, after an all-new Grey's Anatomy, Thursday. Well, it's been life in Austin for the last 3 days. Beautiful day as you look in Darrell K. Royal, Texas Memorial Stadium, where the Longhorns, 7-0 this year. They've won 10 straight in this series. They lead the all-time series, 20 wins and 2 losses against the Cowboys. Look at those touchdown drives.
Look how long. Over 90 the last two.
Whew. Well, they came in number 3 in the country in time of possession. Sometimes that doesn't have any bases on anything. They know what to do when they do have the ball, though. Let's put it that way. Jordan Shipley on a little bit of a slip screen, and that was read beautifully by Donald Booker.
A lot of these passes that Colt McCoy throws are the little slip screen, the little short stuff. But that's not all he throws. But that's why he has such a high percentage. You know, Zach Robinson on the other side had an opportunity to throw some of those little ones also and misconnected.
Now McCoy on second down at 10. He'll give it off to Obanaya. Nice balance by Obanaya. Put his hand down and got out to the 25-yard line. Well, a little bit earlier, we asked you the trivia question. Went like this: what former Oklahoma State javelin thrower went on to become the best-selling solo recording artist in U.S. history? If you've spent any time in Stillwater, I know you know it. Garth Brooks. There's Garth in his cowboy sweatshirt.
Yes, sir.
He's retired and unretired about as many times as Michael Jordan and Muhammad Ali combined.
As long as he keeps singing.
Yeah, just keep singing once a year. That's all you got to do.
That's right.
Blitz may be coming. They back out of it. McCoy in the pocket. Finally finds a man, Cosby, who got planted when he made the catch. But what a catch it was.
That is so good by McCoy. He was getting a little antsy. Had time. He had plenty of time. And there he goes. Throws it. Cosby catches it.
Juan, as Bob said earlier, 4 years in the Angels organization. Now with a helmet on of a different kind. Boy, he took a lick in that last catch, but he held on.
Here's Texas looking over to the sideline now for a checkoff.
They've got a first down at their own 35, so they've already moved it out of the shadow of their own goalposts and out to the 41-yard line on the throw to Shipley.
Now this is a pass play that's open all day long, and Shipley goes down about six, and that's all he has to, and sits down. He finds an opening. McCoy knows where he's going to be open, and he throws him the ball.
That's, you know, he's almost taking the spot of the tight end. They had Finley here last year. He left and went to the pros. Then they got Irby. Irby was hurt, and also Marshall. So they have no tight ends to throw to, and that's why they put Shipley in that spot.
Play action. McCoy's got a man in his face. Completes it, though, down to the 40 to Shipley again. So it's pitch and catch again, and another first down, a pickup of 19. As we take a look at our Dr. Pepper Big 12 update, Texas Tech, Graham Harrell, John talked about it back in the studio. Nebraska won, Oklahoma big on Kansas State. And so now it sets up a showdown. If Texas wins this game today, they go to Lubbock against the Red Raiders next Saturday night. Somebody's got to lose in the Big 12 South. Oklahoma's only lost once. That was to Texas in Dallas a couple of weeks back. McGee's back in the backfield, but it's McCoy to throw. And he completes it to McGee out of the backfield. He's got it down to the 24-yard line. Using a little bit of everything. Greg Davis mixing it up. Colt McCoy gets it to his wideouts, gets it to his running back.
You know, Ness, on this play here, they had five guys out in the pattern. They had three guys down by the 10-yard line. And then they had two guys at the 25.
The guy that Oklahoma State could ill afford to lose in this game on their defense is the guy that's down, and that's Andre Sexton, one of our impact players. Hopefully he's going to be okay. 5:51 to play till halftime. Presentation of college football on ABC presented by Best Buy. Texas 14, Oklahoma State 7. Colt McCoy, not perfect, but pretty close, huh?
Well, 10 yards or fewer, he's completed 13 of 14. And over 11 yards, he's 7 of 8. So a lot of the passes are under 10, 15 yards.
So accurate and efficient, and he's moved his team down to the 25 with 5:45 remaining. He's 20 of 22. One pass has been dropped. Sometimes it's hard to do that just out there with one guy playing catch during practice. Now he's going to run. McCoy, 20. Took a big hit. 15-yard line, and he might have gotten the first down very close to it.
Let's go back to the previous play, Brad. Let me show you something. He's looking for these guys that are running the routes deep. They're going down deep, and he's looking for those guys. But if he can't find them, the back in the backfield is going to just kind of check down, we used to call it, and he's going to hit him right here. That's his outlet. That's his, the guy he goes to if everybody's covered. And that's something new this year that he says, I really feel good about, that if I don't, it's like a security blanket. If I don't have my deep guys, I just dump it off.
Well, this stadium's a security blanket, too. You saw the stat, hasn't thrown an interception this year at home. He won't on this play. It's McGee on the handoff, and Vondrell slipped on his own there, although they were going to help him down, a loss of about two. So it'll bring up second down and 12, 4:50 now remaining in the first half. Texas trying to add to its touchdown lead. 7-0 for the second time in the 11 years under Mack Brown.
And Oklahoma State's forcing this Texas team to throw the ball where the quarterback's only missed two passes. Hello.
You know, what do you do? How do you disrupt a guy like this? The old adage, you put pressure on him. If you can't do it with three guys, four, send five or six. And you leave man-to-man on the outside, though. Here they come.
McCoy to the end zone. Touchdown. Cosby in the corner of the end zone with an acrobatic catch as he was falling down. 17 yards and another Longhorn score. Just an average drive that time for Texas. 80 yards. Lawrence, point after is good. Turn it over to you, Greece. Colt McCoy, his second touchdown throw of the day.
Well, they faked like they were going to blitz, and they came with a blitz, so they're coming straight down the outside. He recognizes what you're doing to him. He knows you can block it. He takes his time. He throws it where you got single coverage, his best guy on your guy.
Watch Quan Cosby now. Pretty good coverage. He has to make the adjustment on the ball in the air and then going down.
Oh, geez, was that a great catch?
That's beautiful.
It's a great catch, but Lacy said to his teammates as he was walking back to the huddle, I lost it in the sun. Now look at, he's looking right into the sun. I don't think he lost it in the sun. That ball was thrown perfectly.
I remember what Lynn Swann used to tell us, if you lose it in the sun, try to catch the sun.
Yeah, that's right. That's right.
So three possessions. Woof. Man, that's pretty strong. You can go a whole season and not do that.
Well, you know, the good thing about that is if you got a long way to go, you get to run a lot of plays.
Yeah.
I mean, you know.
This is the high pooch kick that we expected earlier. Going to be taken at the 19-yard line by Parrish Cox. Cox is an excellent return man. He's got a convoy. Tripped out of bounds or he'd have been gone. I think Brandon Collins or Ben Wells got him knocked out of bounds, but Oklahoma State now has got plenty of time. They can just calm down and say, wait a minute, we got 4 yards, 4 minutes left. We got a 52-yard kickoff return. Let's go back to business.
Boy, you ought to see how he just avoids people. Take a look at this guy. Cox, when he catches the ball, watch him avoid people. He's in the middle of the field. You think someone is going to get a hand on him. Bang, bang, and he goes back to the outside. He really has not been touched yet.
He came in averaging 33 yards a kickoff return. He got 19 plus 33 on that one.
Cox has had 4 kickoff returns for touchdowns in his career.
Remember what Mac told all of us the other day. That's been a problem, and that's the 2 longest kickoff returns allowed by Texas this year have come in this first half. Kendall Hunter on a cutback, but he cut right back into a defender, Roderick McElroy. College football on ABC coming up tonight. This will be a dandy too. Number 3, Penn State taking on Ohio State, ranked 9th. Can the Buckeyes spoil Penn State's unblemished mark? We'll find out tonight. Saturday Night Football presented by Southwest Airlines. Zach Robinson comes up throwing, got it to Pettigrew, the tight end, and he's down to the 20, about a yard shy of the first down.
Did you see Pettigrew? He threw the defensive man into the other defensive man and created his own blocking. I mean, this guy is big, he's strong. I'm telling you, it is funny just watching this guy throw people around.
He's what's become almost a rare combination of being a strong blocker at the tight end spot and then still being able to catch and run like he's done in this first half. 5 grabs for 62 yards for Pettigrew. Now they're overloaded, the Cowboys to the right on 3rd down and 1. There's the bunch. Tostin's a tailback, but it's a quarterback trying to get it, and I don't know. Texas says no, and I don't think he got anything.
He's got to get the ball to the 19-yard line. If he's anywhere, if he's not beyond the 19 or right on the line, he doesn't have it. And he doesn't have it. You've got to go again.
Decision time for Mike Gundy. What do you got, coach?
Well, he's thought all week about plays for this type of situation. And he's got a section on that game plan and his short list for 4th and 1s.
That's what they've got, 4th and 1. Play action. Robinson got it complete. Pettigrew is tight end, as simple as that, out of bounds at the 11-yard line.
Great call, because he had a flanker, first of all, he could have thrown it to. He had a tight end, and then his quarterback could have run it. Unfortunately, the quarterback wasn't going to go anywhere because Kendall was there. The flanker wasn't open, so the tight end got open. First down, good call.
Now they've got it down to the 11-yard line. Think about Dez Bryant. He's up to the top of your screen, number 1. Keep an eye on him. They love to throw the fade to him. On the ground, they keep it to maybe the 9. Lamar Houston made the tackle on Keith Tostin. Don't forget, coming up next, Capital One halftime report. John, Craig, and Doug will give you all the scores and highlights from what's happened earlier. I'm sure they'll talk a little bit about the Big 12 South and Texas Tech and Oklahoma, both with resounding wins earlier this afternoon. 2nd down and 8. The Cowboys could get a 1st down inside the 1. Now Dez Bryant is right where Bob circled him, to the right side. That's where they thought about going, but back across the middle instead, and it's broken up.
Ooh, that was a bad throw there.
Yep. Earl Thomas got a hand on
it. Yeah, he was lucky that one didn't get picked off.
You know what the problem is? And this Texas defense, they know it. They've got two guys that Zach Robinson's throwing to. 87 Pettigrew and number one Bryant, and nobody else.
Here's the end of the play, trying to get it tucked in there to Pettigrew, and a nice play by Thomas, the redshirt freshman safety. Third down. There's the two main targets. Quick slant, touchdown, Oklahoma State, Mo Bowling. Zach Robinson had to rifle that one.
You know how smart this call is? Because they had double coverage on both the tight end Pettigrew and Dez Bryant. And so what did they do? They went to the slot man and threw it to Bo Bowling going across the middle, and nobody, only one guy's on him. Perfect throw, perfect catch.
Second touchdown catch of the year for Bowling. And that quiets the Texas crowd.
These Cowboys said we can score points too.
Absolutely. Dan Bailey for the point after with a minute 15 to go in the half. Kick's good. Here's another look at the touchdown.
All right, here's the guys we're talking about, the big shots. They're going to get doubled, but right here is Bowling. He's just going to run down and come to the inside. Nice throw. Nice throw. You see the double coverage out here. You see the double coverage over here. Bowling got the single coverage. Good read by Zach Robinson.
If you missed a couple of plays early in this drive and you say, how did they cap off just a 29-yard drive in 3 minutes and change to get the touchdown? Remember, they had a 52-yard kickoff return. That's what set up shop for them. So Zach Robinson caps it off with the touchdown pass, his 15th of the year. Good game going on in Austin, Texas. 21-14, number one leads number six. Bo Bowling's going, I'm bowling for dollars, man. There's nothing to this game. Bailey to kick. Quan Cosby at the 10. Flags fly in at the 22-yard line on the return of Cosby, who got it out across the 30. We have had very few flags. Is that the second one all day? It is.
During the run, illegal block in the back. Number one, return team. 10-yard penalty, first down.
That's Tom Walker, our referee today, who hasn't been too busy with the officials. Mike, our Pacific Life game summary, and this one coming in, we knew how efficient Colt McCoy could be. How about 21 out of 23 for 215 yards? A touchdown to Shipley, a touchdown to Cosby, and Texas rolling along. But their lead's been cut now. Bevo's drooling over things a little bit down there. 21-14.
That's a slobber knocker.
he is drooling.
At the 12-yard line, McCoy. Got the screen set up beautifully to Obanyaya, but nice open field tackle in there by Ricky Price to break things up. Stacy?
Well, Brad, as the Oklahoma State defense watched that last touchdown in favor of their team, they had a message to one another, and basically they said, we know what Texas is doing offensively. Basically they said, hey, we got to find a way to get going, and our offense is keeping us in the game. That's got to change.
Well, they know what's coming. They just can't stop it so far, and they can't stop it there. Obanyaya, the senior out of Missouri City, Texas, gets a first down, and they move the chains. Texas has two of their timeouts with 38 seconds in the clock winding down. There's the timeout situation as Grease circle it for you. McCoy, short over the middle. Brandon Collins picked up about four.
I just love the way McCoy is so alert in the pocket. He's aware of the rush, and then he tries to throw the ball. He scrambles around, gets it to somebody. Very aware.
coming up with the Capital One halftime report in about.
That's pretty good timing.
Not bad.
Nice, very nice.
Look at those numbers. 15 straight. Remember, he had 17 straight at one point last week.
I'm enjoying this.
McCoy off play action. There's another completion. Out to the 31-yard line. Short of the first down, though. And the clock winding down.
We got a total of 35 points in the first half. And it's a good ball game.
That's low scoring for the Big 12.
Colt wants to go, and I don't think Texas wants to go. They said, wait a minute, now they're going to call a timeout.
That's going to take a timeout.
Colt talked
them into it. So we'll take it with them. We'll see what the last 3 seconds has in store for us when we come back. Well, right now, Texas has got 302 yards of offense in the first half. Mack Brown's got the headset off. There's one play left. Mike Gundy's likewise knows that he's going to send everybody about 20 miles deep as I see Oklahoma State send four guys back inside the 30-yard line to the left. There they are.
There they are. Way
there's
back.
Just a few DBs back there.
Here's the ball. Here's the play right here.
Now, why not quick slant it across the middle and let somebody try to do something
exactly.
here?
Exactly. Somebody with some speed.
Last play of the half, barring a penalty. It's a little shovel pass inside. Obanaya on a run. Well, might as well roll up another 40 yards of offense before the gun sounds. Oh, boy.
It helps the stats.
Yes. We've had a fun first half. We knew we were going to have one. 21-14, number one Texas leads at the break.